I caught this char from this lake, Coniston Water, back in 1980. Since then, the char fishing on Coniston has declined to the extent that it's hardly worth the effort. Martin Lofthouse and I are going to try a couple of alternative venues, the first of which is Goat's Water. It's a mountain tarn, and reaching it entails a walk of over an hour from the nearest vehicular access. Historically, Goat's Water held good numbers of char, but up-to-date information is difficult to obtain because few anglers visit this remote place. A handful of hikers and rock climbers find their way up here to share the rugged terrain with some hardy sheep. Above the tree line, perspective is easily lost. Goat's Water looks like a puddle, but in fact it's probably around 5 acres in size, with depths to around 40 feet. We've spotted fish rising in the northern half of the lake, and finally start catching a few by suspending worms a couple of feet above the bottom. They're all trout, mostly just 6 or 7 inches long, reflecting the impoverished habitat in which they live. The mountain birds around Goat's Water included this wheatear, and we were also lucky enough to spot a ring ousel. Some of the trout have large heads and thin tapered bodies, and probably predate the minnow shoals which abound in the margins. It's time for the long walk back down the fell. The lake seen here is Coniston Water, and beyond it, the sands of Morecambe Bay. Meadow pipits find the rocky hillside to their liking. The following morning finds us on the banks of Crummock Water, in glorious spring sunshine. After moving swims, Martin starts to catch a few fish, but not the hoped-for char.
It's more like a trout from here.
No, it's a perch.
Oh, it is a perch, yes.
I decide to make the move too. And I'm eventually rewarded with a bite. It's a brown trout of stunning coloration, but it seems the char will have to wait for another day.